Heavyweight prospect Lionel Davis, 9-0 with 7 knockouts. You don't want to get him mad because it will just add to his nice little record over here. I'm here at the Goose and Jimmy Van Nuys talking to Lionel and his trainer. What's the first thing I told you when I walked in here?
I resemble Kimbo Slice.
Does that happen a lot?
I don't even know. This is the first time I heard that from you.
I hope not, though.
Why? He's 2-0 now.
A lot better than him, though. I look a lot better. I'm 9-0, so.
9-0.
What's that saying?
Would you want to fight him?
Yeah, definitely. If the money's right and everything is right, then let's make it happen.
So, Ricky, you were very close to James Toney. You worked with him. You worked with a lot of big fighters here at this gym. What can you tell me about Lionel?
Lionel, great talent. You know, I used to play Division I basketball.
Really? Where'd you play?
I went to University of Idaho. Played all over Euro basketball professionally.
What teams?
Germany League, Italy League, Mexico League, you know, a couple different teams.
Italy's like one of the best leagues in Europe.
Yeah,
what team?
Treviso.
Treviso?
Yeah,
I have a few friends who play out there right now.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, I know, they're making a killing, and they love it.
A lot of money out there.
You speak Italian?
None at all.
So, Ron Artest, I talked to him yesterday, he told me he signed with Mayweather Promotions, and he plans to transition at some point from basketball to boxing. Why did you make that move?
It's in my blood. It's in me. I'm a fighter at heart, you know, but it was an easy transition, you know. I think God has blessed me with the ability to make things happen, and not just one sport, but all sports, so I'm going to use it until the wheels fall off.
So what can you tell me about Lionel Davis, his skill-wise, talent-wise?
I met him 2 years ago when I started working for three years ago. Damn, that long already? I used to work for Michael King. He's trying to find the next American heavyweight. And Lionel was not even a pro yet. He was really green belt.
Yeah, green belt, white belt.
Yeah, you know, but now, you know, he's doing his own thing. He called me and wanted me to help him out, and I'm here. You know, thank God he's giving me the opportunity to hopefully make a name out of myself, you know?
Hopefully. And how do you like the Goose and Jimmy event? I see you got the shirt, you're rocking it.
Oh, I love it, man. This is, you know, it's kind of like all eyes on you, you know? You get the...
Sounds like Tupac.
Yeah, definitely, you know? You get all the, you know, the good work and just, we're here. I mean, they're legendary already, the Goosens. Who don't know about the Goosens, you know?
Just remember the heavyweight division is open, wide open right now. You know, he's 6'7", 250 pounds.
Well, Goosens represent
Chris Arreola.
Who did fight Vitaly Klitschko. Mm-hmm. Who would you want to fight out of the two Klitschkos if you had a choice?
It doesn't matter. Really wouldn't matter.
Who would you want to knock out first, Vladimir or Vitaly?
Well, we have more of the belts.
Well, they both have the belts. But you know what's belts. You know what's funny, Lionel? I come from a basketball background, and I try to train in boxing, but it's upside down and the opposite. Everything's the opposite. In basketball, you're always wide, keep your head up. Mm-hmm. In boxing, you're always tight, keep your net. How did you adjust to that? Where in basketball, it's just different dynamics.
Technique, I think. My footwork, I know how to get away from a lot of things, you know. And basketball, you got to be quick on your feet, you know. So, you know that. A lot of hand-eye coordination. So, I think it helped making that transition over to boxing.
But it's very tough because your instinct, if you run down, you're used to keeping your head up. Try it here in the ring. I'll give you 3 seconds.
I always keep my eye on the guy in front of me. I don't worry about the basketball because if you're good with the basketball, you already know where it's at. It's like a string on a puppet, you know?
Seth Mitchell, very talented heavyweight. I don't know if you saw his fight on HBO a couple weeks ago.
Yes.
He fought in D.C. What do you think about him? He came from a football background.
Yeah, Seth, he's very strong. I mean, he's come a long way, you know, but it's nothing spectacular that I've seen, you know? He's a pretty decent fighter, but at the same time, you know, so am I.
In the history of boxing, who does his style remind you? Is it a Frazier, Ali? Is it a Klitschko? Is it a James Toney?
Kind of Lennox Lewis.
Lennox Lewis?
Yeah, he's tall. And lanky, he uses arms a lot, you know. But, you know, like Joe Goosen taught me before, you know, I have my style, which I learned from Joe, which I'm going to teach him. And he has his style. So he's going to have two arsenals that he's going to be able to use in that ring, you know.
Are you going to get him to spar with Chris Arreola a little?
Maybe in the future, yeah, that will happen. We're just getting him shape right now, trying to work something out, you know.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more. Look out for Lionel Davis. Are you on Twitter? Facebook?
Nah, Facebook.
Okay. What is
Facebook.
It?
At least
So there you have it. Lionel Davis. Look out for him on Facebook for ESNewsReporting.com. From the Goose and Jimmy Van Nuys, I'm Eli Sekback reporting.
Reporting.
And you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekback.
Take a step back.